I am a lifelong resident of the city of New London. I attended public schools K-12 here, and I hold two different teacher licensures in the state of Connecticut. But tonight, I'm not a teacher, I'm a parent. There's been a lot of conversation about tenure. I have huge concerns about that. I have huge concerns about my pay scale possibly going up and down while I pay for a mortgage and my kids to go to college and all of those things based on my principal's yay or nay. But I'm going to talk tonight about being a mom. And I understand that many charter schools have been proven effective. With that success comes a set of rules that does not apply to public school setting. Mandatory extended school days for failing students, mandated parent involvement, and exclusion of certain children as populations. And where do all the kids who do not qualify or do not get into this lottery end up? Sitting next to my son in an overcrowded classroom with a variety of languages at a variety of level with a teacher who's trying to do the best they can. I'm sure that any teacher would tell you that if they could pick their classroom, they would be a success. I want what is best for my child, but I do not feel that sitting on a bus right around town for an hour so that he can end up at a state-approved charter school is the best education decision for a five-year-old.
Right.
So here's my question. Why can't the practices proven or deemed by the state to be effective in schools be implemented and funded in the school around the corner with the great teachers that are already there?
London, the community in which you live and send your five-year-old to school, would receive $810,000 additional. In a time when I think everybody knows there's not a lot of money coming in. This down payment, let me assure you, relates to what I believe we have to do. And that is to concentrate on 30 low-performing districts and make sure that they get more assets and tools, quite frankly, to use to turn around performance. And that includes all kinds of things. I'm not sure I agree with you about everything you would have applied at charter schools. I actually have worked on charter schools. We started a charter school in Stamford to actually take kids who weren't doing well at school. There were only kids who wanted to go to that school, that charter. And we actually then were able to improve the process in those buildings so that on average children were closing 2 years gap in 1 year of education, actually in excess of 2 years gap.
Which is great. My question is, why can't that success, you just stated a proven success, be implemented and offered to a public school setting, a neighborhood school?
I think that's very clear. There's nothing stopping that from happening. There's nothing stopping that from happening right now. In fact, I think one of the frustrations that you're experiencing, and let me assure you, I'm experiencing. I served on a board of education for 5 years, and I served on a local board of finance for 11 years, and I served as a local mayor for 14 years. One of the frustrations I have is that we're not doing that, and we haven't done that. And so we basically continue to do the things each year, and ending up with very similar results. So there's nothing that stops that from happening in current law, and if anything, we're making it easier to do that in this legislation, including sending more money, to your very point, to the district.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
Just curious to follow up on some of your points. Now, remind me, now you're the mother of a five-year-old?
He's four now. He goes to the Magnet, Friendship Magnet School.
How you doing, buddy? You're on the job, I see.
Yep.
It's a...
I'll have to look at that. Kindergarten magnet. He's the first year there.
But my concern is for future down the road,
my husband and I have probably monthly conversations about what to do for him and his education.
Yeah.
Well, the state just has a plan for us too.
And your main concern, if you could just remind me, you had a lengthy preamble to your question.
My concern was that it appears that for districts such as New London, which are one of those failing districts, that one of the proposals for the state is using model schools. And my concern was, why can they not use the practices of what they view model schools in my public schools? So my child can still go to a neighborhood school in his town,
right,
around the corner,
and receive
a high quality education and not have to go on the bus for half an hour to go
right
back to school.
Now I remember, your question was powerful because you were suggesting, if the state has identified methods that work in charter schools, if I may paraphrase, why not apply those across the board out of the gate?
Right.
Why have different charter schools, different public schools, different standards?
Why do they need $3,000 more funding for a charter school initiative and not an initiative in a public school? I mean, you're saying right there, we're going to give you more money, but don't do it in your regular school that you've already built and have staffed. You have to set up a charter school model.
Yeah.
And that's not fair. And charter schools, for parents that want them and agree with them, that is fine. Mm-hmm. I'm not against charter schools. I am for fixing our public schools.
Understood.
So.
All right.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much.